Forsyth basketball, brought to you by Horvey's Builders, and also brought to you by Country Financial and Hickory Point Bank Invested. It is game two of the four-game basketball week set. We got four games all at home, and all four of those games happened to be conference games. We had the girls last night taking the loss against the Pleasant Plain Cardinals. Today we get the boys, and they battle the North Mac Panthers. Here's here tonight, here at home. Hello again, everybody. Welcome to the broadcast booth. In this one, I'm Josh Ryan doing the play-by-play. My partners tonight, John Opperly and Elias Hogue. Hogue's do. They'll be also helping out with me with this game. And this is going to be an interesting game indeed. Of course, apparently from what we saw last night, the Pleasant Plain Cardinals girls team, from what I heard, I think they ended up winning state. That's why they were pretty good. Hopefully the girls will be better on Thursday against the Auburn Trojans. But we are focusing on this game tonight. It's the boys playing the North Mac Panthers. And the North Mac Panthers, they are a very good basketball team right now. Seems like they may be the true favorites tonight, but they may be a top favorite to win the conference besides the Porta Blue Jays and the Pleasant Plain Cardinals boys team. So it's looking like them and Maroa maybe even be in the talks, but we're not sure or what it's going to happen. A lot of very interesting players today here from North Mac and from Maroa as well. And you know what? This is actually a very special game to me because my first ever game I've done, I managed, or any game that I've been, or a sporting event, anything that I've been a part of, with the Maroa Forsyth Trojans, the first ever game I did was a football game at North Mac, which was a very interesting game. It was in the rain, I remember that. Had to borrow somebody's hoodie. Need to keep dry, but we'll tell that story later on. Right now, it's Maroa and it's the Trojans and the Panthers coming up next. A minute and 15 seconds away from the first quarter starting. Once again, the Maroa Forsyth Trojans playing the North Mac Panthers. This is their, I believe, their third conference game of the season. So both boys and girls have played have had at least three conference games this season. We have actually done all three of the girls' games. Actually, you know what? The boys, I think, this is their fourth because they played New Berlin and Williamsville on the road, and then they played Athens here at home, and now they're playing North Mac. And then the girls, their first was against Athens here at home, then the Illinois Central Cougars came here, and then they had the Pleasant Plain Cardinals yesterday. So altogether, we've had seven conference games.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Maroa Forsyth High School for tonight's boys basketball game between the North Mac Panthers and your Maroa Forsyth Trojans. Now please rise and gentlemen remove your hats as we play our national anthem. And now, Trojan fans, welcome the Trojanettes and stand your feet for the playing of loyalty.
The Trojans after that very long introduction. We are about set to go here this evening. So after an almost 10 minute introduction, Northmack will get the ball first, turns it over to number 10, Egan Franzen, and Ethan Jackson goes for the layup. He misses, and that is called on. Oh, timeout. Number one on North Mac had to tie his shoe. Very empty empty gym. There's actually a lot of people here, but the gym just feels very empty. Especially without a student section. And I don't know about you guys, but I miss my student section. That was so much fun. I don't know. I don't really recall what how the student section was like. Our games, I'm pretty sure they were pretty excited, but when the girls were playing, oh, that was a whole lot of fun. Ben Gilbert puts the Trojans on top first. Number one on North Mac had the ball getting loose, and so North Mac will throw it in as Ethan Jackson fouls. Maroa has already had, I believe, the boys team, like I mentioned before, I believe this is their fourth conference game. I could be wrong. I think this is their fourth. They played New Berlin, Williamsville, which were both on the road, and then I believe they've had two at home, one against the Ethan Warriors, and then this game here against the North Mac Panthers. Something going on with number five on the Panthers. Well, he's going to get a foul. So one foul on both Maroa and North Mac here in the first quarter. They, as I mentioned before, my first ever sporting event with Maroa was at North Mac. I remember this very well. North Mac, the North Mac Panthers, we play a lot of Springfield schools, if you don't know. And which means, and from where I live, Springfield is like an hour away from where I live. So the bus rides, whenever we're on the road, it's pretty far. And then they also have to travel pretty far to play us as well. And I think North Mac is actually the longest bus ride. North Mac is like an hour and like 20, 40 minutes away, I think. Almost 2 hours, actually. And so, yeah, the bus ride was very long. Like, hang on a minute. We'll be right back. I'll tell the story after this. As I was saying before, the bus rides from Maroa to the schools we play, like North Mac and Pleasant Plains, Williamsville, and New Berlin, the bus rides are very long because Springfield's pretty, where they are, it's pretty far from where we are. And so the bus rides were very long. There was rain in the forecast where we were at. There was actually a football game against North Mac. So, but yeah, it was supposed to rain really bad. I thought, you know what, I don't think I need a hoodie because it was still August. And well, first quarter the weather was still good. And then around second and third quarter was when it just started pouring. I remember me, the other manager at the time, Damon Campbell, if he's listening to this, Damon, what's up? And a few other JV player managers. They were, me and him and all those guys were sitting in the bowl, had to sit in a trailer where we keep all of our equipment at. And we just sat in there for like 5 minutes trying to keep dry. But yeah, it was a pretty good game. We won. Their locker room is very fun. Or interesting locker room. I guess I should give you guys a scoreboard update. It's 4 minutes, 41 seconds. North Mac just fouled. That's their second foul. Maroa 6. North Mac has not yet scored. Egan Franzen, 7 points so far. And they're going to call a timeout. call at after the timeout called. Neil Diamond, Sweet Caroline, playing in the background. Sweet Caroline, mom, mom, mom. 4 minutes, 32 seconds left. Scores 8-0. Maroa leads. Northmack with the ball. Northmack finally gets on the board. It's 8-2. Thanks to number one, redhead kid. I believe they said he was a senior. Ben Gilbert with the ball. Ball gets loose. Northmack with the steal. Number one gives it to number four. It bounces off. This is a 6-point game. Egan Franzen trying to keep it from going out of bounds. Mentor Balazi with the three, misses. I guess one more thing. Like I said before, there will be two audio tapes coming out Thursday and Friday, and then a bonus tape coming out Saturday. There will be no audio tape tomorrow because it's Wednesday and we don't have games on Wednesdays. Girls will play Thursday against the Auburn Trojans. And then I believe the boys are playing the Riverton Hawks. And then on Saturday, boys and girls both play. Boys will go to Sullivan to play the Redskins, while the boys while the girls will play the St. T. Bulldogs again. That's right. We'll have another St. T. game. This time it'll be the girls edition. It's gonna be fun watching St. T. blow us out again. Possibly. I don't know. Enough about St. T, let's talk about Northmack. This is now a 3-point game. Two fouls now on Maroa. Followed up by a third foul on Ben Gilbert. And Jack Appleby's gonna come in the game for him as Coach Ennis takes Ben Gilbert out. If you guys want a summary of how the JV game went, well, it was an easy win for Maroa. Even though Maroa has a small JV team. I think they only had seven guys on their JV team. Really? Yep. Maybe if I came back and played JV, then maybe I'd help them out a little bit more. Northmack coach groans in frustration. Screen! Or fall to the floor. Okay, that works too. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left. Gives it to number four. He doesn't know what to do. He's going to give it to number one. Going for the three. And he didn't get it. And he sucks. Wade Joseph, the number one on Maroa, gives it to Landon Albert. Wade Joseph, a three-sport athlete. He's the quarterback for Maroa. And then he also plays basketball in the winter and track in the spring. And I'm going to have to, and I will say these next few months are going to be very busy for him and his dad, Coach Josh Joseph, head coach of the Maroa Forsyth Trojans, because you got basketball right here. After basketball, we're going to have football practices start next week. So him and a majority of the kids, or all the guys that play football, they're going to have to figure out their schedule, how they're going to do this. And there are three kids, I believe, on the football, or that don't play football, that are on the basketball team. So yeah, like I said before, I hope Coach Ennis and Josh Joseph figure out, you know, what they're going to do with football and basketball. Same with the girls in volleyball too. I didn't even think about volleyball because volleyball is not really my sport. And then when football and basketball, and then when that's over, then they got track. First game is on March 20th for football. And if you guys want me to, I can try and do audio tapes for the football games. However, those might be a little bit harder because, like I said before, I manage, and that's gonna be harder because in football I have a lot more work to do. And on the sidelines, I'm not allowed to have my phone out. So I don't know if I will be able to do audio tapes for football. Same with volleyball, I probably won't do that because it's an indoor sport. And I think a limited amount of people can get in the game. But if somehow somebody gives me a ticket, maybe to a varsity volleyball game sometime, or if it's like a special game, I guess, for volleyball, then I will post it. But besides that, I'm not doing volleyball. And football is going to be tricky. Ethan Jackson makes a half-court shot. Him and the Trojans lead 14-9. Going into the second quarter. And the second quarter is off and going. And mentor Balazzi makes the score 16-9. Number 12 with a layup almost trips. And it's 16-11. North Mac now trails by 5. But yeah, as I said before, people have been asking me to do audio tapes for other sports. I could try, though that I don't know. Football games, it's going to be hard. And then volleyball games are going to be harder too because, one, I don't really watch volleyball. Out of all the sports that Maroa has, I am not very active, I guess, in supporting the volleyball team. I mean, I support it, but I'm like a casual volleyball fan, I guess. And if I do somehow get into a game, if there's any volleyball players on Maroa there's listening to this tape, if you guys are gonna have tickets, if someone could sneak me in a ticket, then I will, or something, then I will post an audio tape for the girls volleyball team. And then, but for football, that's gonna be hard. And then people have been asking me to do non-Maroa games. Again, that's gonna be hard. Because Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and occasionally Saturday. Yeah, I don't know if I'll be able to do non-Maroa games. Probably by the time I graduate, then I could do non-Maroa games. So, a majority of these games will be involving the Maroa Forsyth Trojans. Or maybe if there's a shootout next year, if they have shootouts next year. And if we happen to be early for a game or something, then yeah, maybe I'll do it from there. But I don't know. All right, enough about the updates. Back to the game. It's a 3-point game, 16-13 to score. Jacob Blunk coming in from his chair. Aaron Ennis pulled him out. Him and Egan Franz are both going in. And Landon Albert just fouled. A free throw for number one on North Mac. He makes the score 16-14. The score was originally 8-0, and now it's 16-14. North Mac making a comeback. Well, they could possibly. I don't know. Anyway. All right, they don't get it. It's a 2-point game. Mentor Bosley with the ball from Maroa gives it to Ben Gilbert. Gives it to Mentor, shoots in, doesn't get it. Oh, well. And another foul on Maroa, this time on Jacob Blunk, who just came into the game. Egan Frangin makes this a 4-point game, 18-14. And number five for North Mac gives it down to number one, or passes it down to number one. Number two passes it back to number five, who passes it back to number two. Mentor Bowsy with the ball again. Jacob Blunk, or Jameson Allen, excuse me. Jacob Blunk watches his friend Jamie Allen make a shot. And it's a 6-point game. Number five for North Mac out with the ball again. There's 4 minutes and 47 seconds left of the second quarter. Holy cow, this quarter has gone by very, very slow. First up, I will say I really like North Mac's jerseys. They got they had black for JV, and then their varsity team is blue. Kind of like a North Carolina color. I like it. If I had to give their jerseys or rate their jerseys on a scale of 1 to 10, put them at an 8. Kind of again, they're like North Carolina colors, except for North Carolina's not doesn't have black in their team colors, I don't think. But yeah, that's what it reminds me of, North Carolina Tar Heels, where Michael Jordan went to college. You ever seen the Space Jam movie where Michael Jordan's playing basketball with the Looney Tunes? You remember the start of the movie, where, the beginning of the movie? It's like Michael Jordan as a little kid. He goes, I'm going to play basketball. I'm going to go to college in North Carolina, and then I'm going to go play baseball. I don't know if Michael Jordan was thinking about going to North Carolina, and I don't know if he said those exact words to his dad, but what do I know? I'm not Michael Jordan. All right, score's 22-17. We'll be right back. Also, one more thing. I apologize, the tape from last night, Moreau and Pleasant Plains, the girls' tape. I apologize, it took a long time to upload. My phone almost died, and I didn't have my charger. But I got my charger now. I got it back. So, yeah, we're good to go. 25-19 after the layup from number one on North Mac. That's it. He's now got 5 points today. The leading scorer today for North Mac is number five. That's on the court right now. Number five for North Mac. He's got 9 points today. While leading scorer on Maroa, that's in the game right now, looking like Egan Franzen with number five misses a layup. 23, Jacob Blunt gives it down, passes it down to number 5, Ethan Jackson. Gives it back to Wade Joseph. 2 minutes left to go. And the whistle was blown. And North Mac will throw it in. And turnover on Maroa. North Mac gets the ball back. You know, now that I'm looking at it, or looking at the schedule, the only team I believe Maroa doesn't play this year, but they played last year, was the Hayworth Hornets. I don't think we have a game with Hayworth this year. We played them last year. First game was at Hayworth, and then for the boys, I don't know if the girls played Hayworth, but I'm pretty sure they did. But then again, what do I know? 25-21 with 80 seconds left to go here in the second quarter. Uh-oh. Trouble. Minute 12. That's his second, 26-21. Ben Gilbert on the free throw. And a minute 10. Sixty seconds left to go. Guys, if you are new to the Let's Talk Sports YouTube channel, make sure to drop a like on this tape. Subscribe if you're new here. Comment down below. Anything random, or let me know in the comments if you guys want me to continue these tapes. Plus, we are 20 subscribers away from 300. If basketball season is still going on, by the time we have 300, we could live stream one of the games, if we could. It's a high school game. I don't really think they would mind. Besides, a lot of my friends know I do YouTube it anyway, so... yeah, couldn't hurt the live streaming game. Number 5, Ethan Jackson. But the ball, 45 second, Remernan. We had the Trojanettes, the Maroa Forsyth dance team, coming out today instead of the cheerleaders. I guess this is going to be an every other day thing where the cheerleaders come out. I mean, the cheerleaders were out here yesterday, so dance team gets their turn today, which isn't a bad thing. I don't mind the dance team. In fact, I think the dance team's a little underrated. Dance team needs more love. You know what I mean? Seconds left to go. Number 12 gives it to one, shoots and scores, and we got a tied game on the three. Tied game after the first half. North Mac ties it after the second quarter. final buzzer shot for number one ended up tying it with a three. Egan Franzen hands it to Jackson. Joseph's mentor to Franny, back to Ethan Jackson. Takes the lead as Jackson and shoots and scores. And number four ties it for North Mac. If you're an Atlanta Falcons fan, that's a very familiar score. Super Bowl 51, Falcons and Patriots in Houston, Texas. Falcons had the lead and blew it. Patriots came back and Tom Brady won his fifth of seven in Super Bowls. Tom Brady won his first back in 2002 against the Rams. And he beat the... Wait a minute, Ennis is ranting. Or he's raging. Anywho. Brady won his Super Bowl number two against the Carolina Panthers. Hey, speaking of Panthers, we happen to be playing the North Mac Panthers. And if you're wondering how they are in football, well, the North Mac Panthers play exactly like the Carolina Panthers do. They're just a meh team. And Carolina Panthers, they're just meh. Not good, not bad, just meh. That basically describes the Carolina Panthers for you. Anywho, Tom Brady won Super Bowl number three against the Eagles and then lost back-to-back against the Giants and Eli Manning. Didn't get another Super Bowl ring until Super Bowl 49 against Russell Wilson and the Seahawks. 51 came against Matt Ryan and the Falcons. Went to three Super Bowls in a row, two more Super Bowls, lost to Carson Wentz and the Eagles, and then beat Jared Goff and the Rams. And then just won his most recent Super Bowl with the Buccaneers against Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs. Foul on Ethan Jackson in this game. Number one with a free throw, he tied it. Back in the, to end the first half of the game. And now the game's tied again. It was a good first quarter. And then second quarter was flat. It's how Maroa seems like is doing right now, or all season. They play a good first half, and then second half they're just flat. And then third quarter, well, they kind of play flat, but at the same time they try to be better. And then fourth quarter, it depends whether they're winning or losing. They'll play flat or they play good. Number five shoots and misses. Egan Franzen gives it to number 13, Mentor Balazi. who has scored 5 points today. Ball goes out. Timeout called on Maroa. We'll be right back. If you watch Draft Night Mark, a big baseball YouTuber, if you remember, he did MLB The Show back in the day. Whenever he did pack openings, that was actually the, I think that was the music he used. Whenever he did pack openings, and a bunch of other shows as well. Yeah, number five, get up! Don't be a you-know-what. Game's tied at 29. 4 minutes, 25 seconds left of the third quarter. Number five on North Mac with a steal, gives it to 20, the 12. Off the rim, stupid shot. I know, Mr. North Mac coach, I agree. That was a bad shot. North Mac ties it again at 31. Egan Franzen to Wade Joseph. Shoot the ball, mentor. There you go. Timeout called. And Aaron Ennis, Coach Ennis, he's got quite a bit to say today. Guys, I just now realize, usually we do the home team for the first half of the game, of the photo, and then the second half we have a the picture of a of the away team's logo. I forgot to put the North Mac logo for the third, for the second half. So here's the North Mac logo for you. It's a ripoff to my middle school. They have this logo too. Oh yeah, I forgot my middle school is called the Panthers. Shut up. Shut up and drink a Red Bull. Okay, don't drink a Red Bull, or then he'll get more pissed. That's a North Mac coach screaming his head off, if you're wondering. Their JV coach looks like a girls wrestler manager, or like he'd bet on wrestling matches. And I'm sorry, but the North Mac head coach, or their varsity coach, he does not look like, this guy looks like he knows absolutely nothing about basketball. He does not look like a basketball coach. I'm sorry, anybody from North Mac listening to this, no offense, but your coach looks nothing, and I mean nothing, like a basketball coach. In fact, he looks more, or like a football coach. And this guy needs, this guy needs to calm down. Anyway, game's tied at 34 again. We're seeing that a lot here in the second half. Game's tied again. North Mac's got a chance to take the lead. They're throwing it in. And they don't take that lead. They got a chance, though, with a free throw for number 12. Enough nitpicking about people's appearances. I mean, this is a fan-made audio tape. I'm supposed to make... That's what these fan-made tapes are supposed to be about. They're supposed to be serious, but a little bit of comedy as well. Gotta have a little bit of comedy, too. And if the North Mac head coach is listening to this, I'm sorry. You just don't look like a basketball coach. I mean, if this guy, if I were to pick, like, I would much rather have the worst coach ever, like some guy on the streets that knows nothing about basketball, coach my high school basketball team, which, all right, we're done. North Marquette, his team has the lead, 35-34, and enough talking about North Mac's coach. And Jacob Blunk and Ben Gilbert coming into the game for Maroa. Oh, never mind. Ben Gilbert's just switching chairs. Though I think he is about to come in. Been a while since North Max made a substitution. They might pull somebody in from the game. Or they might take somebody out and take somebody else in. Maroa trails by three. Oh, no. A minute 25 left to go. Everybody's clapping for some reason. Mentor makes this a one-point game. Number one with another three. And it's 40-36. Maroa back on offense. 40-36. And it's a two-point game. 25 seconds left to go to the third quarter. North Mac gets the ball back. Egan Frangin misses the steal. Number one misses a layup. Number 14 on Maroa, Landon Albert. Gives it to number five, Ethan Jackson. Back to Mentor Balzi. And he misses. It's okay, though. It's a two-point game. 40-38 your score. Bruce Springsteen playing in the back. Born in the USA. Cheesy song, but it's okay. Kind of cheesy. If you've seen, there were pictures of Bryce Harper at the at spring training, taking BP for the Phillies, and he had this, he would make like custom cleats with the Phillies stuff on it, and then he had a custom bat of the Phillies mascot. And, that's actually pretty cool. I mean, some people may think it's cheesy to have a custom bats kind of like that, but, I mean, not the worst thing in the world. I thought it was pretty cool to have, like, as memorabilia, if you like to collect baseball stuff like I do. So, yep, spring training starts. Games actually start next week. It is on the 28th, I think. It is the first day of spring training games. St. Louis Cardinals playing the Washington Nationals. Either they're playing the Nationals or the Marlins, I don't know. Seven minutes left of the fourth quarter. And the North Mac coach is paying the ref because he just put his shoulders on him. put his hands on that ref. But hey, man, you're not supposed to touch the ref. Oh, shit. Tied game. Deegan Frangin saves Jacob Blunt. Foul on 23. Jacob Blunk again just came into the game. Last time he came into the game, fouled. Same thing again. Damn it. Excuse my Spanish. The other foul on Moreau this time, Jimmy Allen. Oh, you're not supposed to do that. What are you doing? That's basketball one-on-one. That's the first thing they teach you in basketball. Jesus. Well, Northman takes the lead, 42-40. 6 minutes, 13 seconds left. Northmac with the ball back. Come on, D. Number one. Another three. It's 45-40. On the floor. That was the Northmac coach again. Timeout called. Please don't play music. Please don't play music. Everyone. 5 minutes and 23 seconds left. Northmac leads by a three. They have the ball back again. He gives it to number one. He's got 19 points. Number 12 has 6 points today. It's 48-42. Landon Albert missing a layup. To 42. Ben Gilbert makes the layup. They don't count though. Foul on Northmac. And a timeout has been called. To 42 is your score. Five fouls now on both teams here in the second half. Ben Gilbert misses the first free throw shot. Bro now trails by eight. They start off the game leading 8-0. Now they trail by seven. Oh boy, this is like Saint T all over again. Except Saint T was a much tougher school than they were. Number 10 misses a three. Albert swats it away. Yeah. Foul on number one. His first. Team sixth of the day, or of this half. 44-50. Egan, number 10 with 18 points. Is that what it says? 18? I think so. He's 1-for-2. Wade Joseph saves it. Gilbert. It is off the rim on the corner three. Oh my goodness. All right, six fouls now on both teams. This one on Egan Frangin. Imagine fouling after scoring a free throw. After making somebody just foul. He made somebody foul, and now he fouls again? I don't think I've ever seen that in basketball before. It's happened, but I don't know. To me, that just seems a little bit weird. Fouling after making somebody else foul. Friends into Wade Joseph. Another screen play. Goes for the layup. Makes it. It's 50-46. Let's go, Maroa. All right. 3 minutes left. Number one on North Mac still has the ball. Number five for the ball now for the Panthers. Number 12 with the ball again. Back to number one. Yeah. 52-46. Two minutes, 20 seconds left. 52-46. Also, love how we kept all the audio from this game. Ball gets loose. Number two recovers. Number five on North Mac gives it back to number two. He kicks it away. Jack Appleby with the steal. Wade Joseph to Albert. And another foul on North Mac. Albert. 52-47. Landon Albert with his first shot of the night. He's 1-for-2 on the free throw shot. 1:50 left to go. Timeout called on North Mac. Don't go anywhere. 1:49 left to go. Hey, there's a song we've been waiting for. It's a 5-point game with 1:43 to go left to go. Number five traveled on North Mac, but off the rim. 90 seconds left to go. Come on, Jack. Appleby trying to make a steal. Number two making the layup. And it's 54-47. North Mac with the ball back. Oh my goodness, seven fouls now on Maroa. Seven fouls now on both teams. Number four of the free throw shot. For the North Mac Panthers. That's not a very good idea to call out a play. In the middle of this. In the middle of a free throw shot. That's not a very good idea. Calling out a play. Yeah, it's in scenario. 56-50. On the three by Albert. Six-point game now with 56 seconds left to go. North Mac throwing it in. And another timeout called. Once again, a six-point game. Whistle blown. That's a foul on Moreau. That is on Ben Gilbert. North Mac may make this into a two-point game. Seven-point game. Eight-point game. 50 seconds left now. This is an interesting fourth quarter. Like I said before, this is going to be an interesting game. It's been very interesting. Another foul on Ben Gilbert. That is a. Not very good. Number five on North Mac. Could make this a 10-point game. Oh my God. 37 seconds left. Mentor Balazzi. Balazzi, 60-52. North Mac coach, shut up. 30 and a half seconds left to go. Foul on Franny. Oh my God, not again. Franny shouldn't have reached for it. Ten fouls now on Maroa. Tenth one came from number 10. Now this is a 10-point game again. Landon Albert. 62-55. 14 seconds left to go. Number one on North Mac now with 27 points tonight. And this game is over. The Panthers take this game on the road, 64-55. What an embarrassing loss for the Trojans. Post-game show coming up. Tune in on Thursday when the girls play the Auburn Trojans. It'll be the battle of the Trojans, bro. Forsyth and the Trojans and the Auburn Trojans.